Hi friends, welcome back to Techie Trainers. My name is Shivakumar Reddy. As part of Docker tutorial series, in our previous sessions, we installed Docker, we practiced Docker commands, even it was a little boring, you practiced really well. Now let us discuss about Docker architecture, how the Docker is working internally. Okay, so first in Docker architecture, so there is Docker client. Docker client is nothing but Docker command only. And we have Docker daemon or sorry, Docker engine. This Docker engine consists of few components, that is Docker daemon, Docker daemon is nothing but, if it is a client, this is server or service. So server or service usually responds to the client. So whenever you run a Docker command, it reaches the Docker daemon, then it will connect to the container D, this is called Docker runtime. So you'll understand more about these things later. So whenever, for example, you run Docker run nginx command, so this will reach Docker daemon, then Docker daemon will pass, like Docker daemon will check there is something called local image repository. So this will check whether the image is available locally inside the host. This is all our, so this is happening inside our host, right? I mean our server VM. So whenever you run Docker run nginx here, it reaches our Docker daemon, then it will check whether any image is already available or not. If it is available already, then it will fetch it and then pass to the container D, so that it can create the container out of it. If this is not available here, then it will fetch it from the Docker Hub. So Docker Hub is a public repository. By default, every Docker is configured to connect to the Docker Hub. Okay, so we can see a lot about this. If you are running this command first time in your host, definitely this is not available here. It will bring the image from here. Will bring the image from here to the local. Next time if you run this command again, since the image is already available here, it will not connect with Docker Hub. Okay? So like this it will happen. So this is the overall architecture of Docker. We can see more about these components, like what is container D, all these things in detail in our upcoming session. So but you see, just one recap again, whenever you run Docker command, it reaches the Docker engine running in your server, then Docker daemon receives this command, then it will check whether this image is already available or not. If it is not available, it will pull from the Docker Hub, then it passes to the container D to create the container out of image. Container D is nothing but one component of Docker engine called container runtime. Okay, so this is all about Docker architecture. So in our upcoming videos, we can discuss about what is Docker file, how can we create our own images, how can we push our images to the public repository so that others can use our images. So all these things. Okay.